Did Velociraptor look like a bird or a dinosaur? Welcome to the Natural History of Dinosaurs. My name is Benjamin Berger. I'm a paleontologist teaching at Utah State University in the heart of Utah's dinosaur country in Vernal. So Jurassic Park and other movies and films on dinosaurs have sold us on the idea that Velociraptor was this scaly, reptilian-like creature. But new scientific evidence is starting to shed light on the fact that these maniraptorian theropod dinosaurs share a lot in common with birds. So I thought in this video we would briefly go through and look at the skeleton of Velociraptor. And maybe Velociraptor looked like this rather than this. Now the first thing that's really different in Velociraptor from birds is that it has these nasty, sharp-looking teeth. And of course, all birds lack teeth and they have a beak. So sharp teeth is found only in Velociraptor and these theropod dinosaurs. When you look at the brain of Velociraptor, Velociraptor had a small brain case compared to birds. This whole bird brain thing is a misnomer, as birds have developed fairly large brains, mostly because they need to make quick decisions when they are in flight. Now, Velociraptor has a long, bony tail, which is lost in birds. The tail in birds is composed out of feathers, with the last bone, the pygostyle, ending not far from the butt. In the hand, Velociraptor has claws, three fingers, each with a claw. But in birds, these three fingers are fused together and they form this carpal metacarpus bone, the wing bones. Similar, but different. What about in the foot? Velociraptor still retains three distinct metatarsal bones, which in birds fuse to form a single bone, the tarsal metatarsus bone. So, another difference. What about the wishbone, the furcula? Well, it's found in theropod dinosaurs, although it is much smaller and it's not as functional as in birds. Here's the wishbone in Tyrannosaurus rex. What about that keeled sternum that you find in birds? Well, here's the sternum in yellow of Velociraptor, which is not keeled, and it's not fused together like in birds, and it's still pretty small. And what about that big weird syncrum in the hip that birds have? Well, Velociraptor has a dinosaur hip with the ilium and ischium and the pubis and an open acetabulum. Note that the pubis is starting to project a little further backward than we saw with other saurischian dinosaurs, and this is kind of interesting. Now, finally, we have feathers, and dinosaurs such as Velociraptor had feathers. Note that along the ulna, we see these little bony tubercles, the same ones that we find in modern turkeys and other birds. These tubercles are sites where we had long feathers that came off the arm. And we see this in living turkeys and we see this in Velociraptor. So despite having a skeleton that's more dinosaur-like, the feathers that covered Velociraptor probably made it look a little bit more like a giant turkey than a lizard. But don't fret with this new image of Velociraptor. It still had those nasty, scary looking teeth. Alright, be able to compare and contrast the skeleton of a maniraptorian theropod like Velociraptor with a skeleton found in a typical bird.